Singles Meet and Gist with Freshman is a moment where singles get to listen to a relationship expert by name Freshman Jay. These moments are filled with lots of single games, talk shows, and hookups. It's an opportunity for singles to get to mingle, to yield impact on each other. In these moments, singles get to meet and listen to couples that have been successfully married for years. Here, the couples get to give them nuggets of wisdom that has helped them come very far in their marriage. In this particular edition, we had Pastor and Pastor Mrs. Ebenezer Gift Obiora of Life of Faith Gospel Assembly as guests. They talked about having an inner sense of conviction, compatibility, value alignment, like beliefs, what you feel and say. They also said that there must be quarrels in a relationship, but what makes you a partner indeed is the ability to dialogue, solve the problem, and move on. During the hookup section, we sure got to hook up people who admire each other. The smiles on Miss Rachel and Mr. Uche's face shows that they are truly in love with each other. They also got a gift from the host, Mr. Freshman. The gift is a book written by him titled Marriage Counseling and Singles Issues.
From our hookup section, just look at the palliatives we have here.
About the Rachel Tina.
My name is Uche Chukwu.
So what did you see in her during the hookup section?
I see everything.
Natural likeness.
Another hookup that took place was between Miss Ifeoma Aniekwe from Nando and Mr. Emmanuel from Umuleri. They were so happy. They said they came and conquered.
In everything, I like his program.
Oh. Aww. Sir, how did you get to know about Freshman and this program of his?
Okay, just like I've said before, I am a fan of Freshman. I am his ardent follower in every social media platform and on radio. So any week he's supposed to, you know, be on radio, and I don't listen to him. It's as if I have missed something very tangible.
I hope you're happy that you met such a wonderful palliative.
Yes, of course.
And you?
Yeah.
So what state are you from?
I'm from Ebony State.
Ebony, are you?
I'm from Cross River.
So be the right person for him, and you be the right person for him. What's your name, pretty?
My name is Ifeoma Aniekwe.
Ifeoma Aniekwe, from which state?
From this Anambra State, but Nando.
My name is Ndivechi Bozo Emmanuel.
From which state?
From this very state. I'm from Umuweri.
How did you get to know about this program?
Over 4 years now, I keep listening to Freshman. All the program he's doing, I'm always there.
Wow.
I believe in him. I like his program. I can't listen to any radio apart from him.
And I find my choice.
Actually, I used to listen to Freshman's program. And when I heard his, the last one he did at my very community where I did not attend that one. So I said I will not fail this one. My spirit was telling me to.
Hey!
This
is your spirit. This is your spirit.
And I came and I conquered.
We also spoke with the host and his wife by name, Mr. and Mrs. Freshman and Amarachi Wanze. He said that what prompted him to start a program like this was because they want young ones to be free, learn, and ask questions, giving them a chance to be themselves. This is the first singles edition this year. By October, he will hold the second edition here in Onitsha. Meanwhile, he said there will be a media tour to universities and other towns for singles. He also has a program for married ones.
Okay, my name is Freshman Osinachi Wanse. That's my full name. And of course, Meet and Gist has been there. This is the first edition of 2021, because normally we have it twice a year. So the next edition, the second edition for this year, will be coming soon. We had the last edition, that was November 2020, last year 2020. And this God helped us this the first edition for 2021.
Mrs. Amarachi Jennifer.
While growing up, I I never had the opportunity of attending a program like this, actually. You know, in church programs, people don't feel that free to ask the kind of question they want to ask, because they look at it that when you ask certain questions, people will look at you as a sinner. You know, without knowing that Jesus even loves sinners, not sin. You know, but the platform we are trying to create is just to help young people to be free. Because it's when somebody is free, the person will be able to express himself, be able to ask the right questions. So my motivation is God. We believe we can do this without actually calling the church, but at the same time, we achieve the same aim that pastors want to achieve. But we achieve it better because we give people the chance to be themselves and not try to pretend who they are not.
During and after the program, we interviewed the participants, and here are their reviews.
All right, this is the family of Mr. and Mrs. Obiora, Ebenezer, and Gift.
Okay. All right. I think I'll be talking from my own experience. I actually got to know he was the one because of how I was feeling inside of me. I had this hunger to speak to him more, to see him more. And of course, I started praying to know if he's the one. So first, what you feel, then you put it to prayer.
Okay, I'll say that what made me think that she is the right one was, first of all, just seeing her first, I had this inner sense of conviction. And then there was something that happened to me. After meeting her, I stopped seeing any other girl as beautiful. She was the only beautiful girl in my eyes, to be very honest with you. That's the first thing. And then, I don't know, but I could speak. You know, when she said that we spoke from 9 a.m. to 3 a.m., we don't do it every day, but trust me, if you can speak with a woman from 9 a.m. to 3 a.m., it means that both of you are compatible. For you to have words that can last that long. So, not just that I had conviction, there was compatibility. Okay? There was conviction, there was compatibility. And then, of course, I couldn't see any other beautiful person. Until now, I don't. I don't see anybody more beautiful than her. Then, of course, she aligns with my values. I'm a Christian, okay, and she is also a Christian. From my interaction with her, I see that she is a Christian indeed. Honest, genuine, faithful, because that's one of the qualities that you need in marriage.
Oh, I would advise single like us to always listen and always attend programs like this. Always look up to people who are married, who are probably your mentor, either spiritually or...
Wow. I say kudos. Seeing him only gives me encouragement. Yes, because God have really blessed him by giving him that kind of initiative, bringing young people. In fact, this kind of gathering is a gathering that we lack in our various areas, especially in our churches. And another thing I love about his program is that he made it godly.
In all things, we will give thanks to God and pray harder. Because marriage is not an easy thing, you understand? Likewise in relationships.
I used to learn a lot from him. Listening to him gives me hope, motivates me. The most importantly, the way he talks about God, he puts God first when he's encouraging people. So that used to burst my brain.
It is not obvious on a moment like this, we ought to, you know, follow the right path. Listening to a freshman Jay is one of the ways that if our youth can learn, actually, they must get to the destination, especially in terms of marriage affairs.
I'm here to prepare myself as a youth, understand, to know the type of relationship I'm going into, people I hook around with, and what I want in relationship.
I didn't come on time, but at least for the little time I have spent so far, I think I'm enjoying the conversation. Yeah.
So far, so good. What have you learned?
Okay, freshman talks about self-drives in men. You know, one of those things our women complain, or our single ladies complain nowadays, is the high demand for sales from their male counterparts. And I think Freshman has really done justice to that subject to a very large extent, in the sense that he's making us to understand that this thing is natural. And despite the fact that it's that way, it's also controllable. So it's just a kind of understanding. Every lady should understand that men has this thing in them. So it's not just a kind of a different hormone that was manufactured somewhere. They have it in them. It's just to kind of strike this conversation from the beginning and know how it goes.